सिसाल्पिनेसी, सिसाल्पिनेसी फैमिली, द सिसाल्पिनेसी फैमिली इज आल्सो कॉल्ड कैसिया फैमिली, सिसाल्पिनेसी फैमिली इज आल्सो कॉल्ड कैसिया फैमिली. नाउ लेट्स बी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द सिस्टमैटिक पोजीशन ऑफ सिसाल्पिनेसी. It is first classification or systematic position of Cisalpinaceae. Class dicotyledons. Dicotyledon characters are four here. One is tap root system, reticulate venation of leaves, pentamerous or tetramerous flowers, and embryo or seed containing two cotyledons. These are the class dicotyledon characters. Now next subclass, polypetale. Polypetale means petals are free in position. They are arranged in the second whorls of the floral parts. Petals are free in position. Next series, calyciflorae. The calyciflorae series shows perigynous flowers with half superior or half inferior ovary. Sometimes hypogynous flowers also placed in the calyciflorae series. Next order rosales. In rosales orders, marginal placentation is present. The marginal placentation is present in the rosales order. Now family is leguminaceae. The leguminaceae family is also called Fabaceae SI, Sensu I2, Fabaceae SI. The leguminaceae or Fabaceae family classified into subfamilies. In that subfamily, one of the subfamily is Cisalpinioidae, Cisalpinioidae. The Cisalpinioidae classified in advanced classification as a Cisalpinaceae. Cisalpinioidae classified into Cisalpinaceae family in advanced classification. But according to Bentham-Hooker classification, the Cisalpinaceae is under leguminaceae family as a Cisalpinioidae family, Cisalpinioidae subfamily. Now let's be discussed about these some plants from this family. Cassia auriculata, tangedu. Cassia auriculata, tangedu. Cassia accidentalis, casinda. Cassia accidentalis, casinda. Delonix rhizia, erraturai. Delonix rhizia, erraturai. Bahinia wahli, bahini wahli, addaku. Bahini wahli, addaku. Parkinsonia. Including this family, some major plants are here like Pterolobium, Tamarindus indica, Saraca indica. These are the another important plants of this family. Now let's be discussed about the vegetative characters, floral characters, and economic important characters of this family. Now first, before the explanation of vegetative characters, Cisalpinoidae have about 153 genera and 2,175 species are distributed in tropical regions. In India, they are about 23 genera and 80 species are present. And comes to the habitat. Habitat mainly, the Cisalpinaceae family plants are shows mesophytic plants. CRT is the mesophytic plants. It is the Cassia accidentalis, Cassinda. It is the true plant picture. And Cassia auriculata, Tangedu. These are the major plants for explanation of this family characters. So these plants developed in the mesophytic region. So the habit of Cisalpinaceae belongs to mesophytes. They developed in the mesophytic region. And habit is majority of the plants are trees, like Tamarindus indica, Saraca indica. These plants are trees. And the shrubs also present. Here it is the Cassia auriculata. These plants are called Cassia auriculata plants, like Tangedu. These plants are called shrubs. And some climber plants also here in this family, woody climbers. They are also called lions. Bahinia wahili. The plants are act as a lions. They are climbing plants. And next comes to the root system. The root system of these plants, mainly tap root system and branched root system present in the plants. Here it is stem. First we discuss the next point is stem pod. Aerial, erect, green in color, smooth surface or granular surface. Smooth surface or glandular surface. In Cassia accidentalis, the stem is in smooth manner, smooth surface. But in Cassia auriculata, the stem surface is in hairy surface. Hairy surface is present. In some plants, like in Pterolobium, Pterolobium containing thorns on the stems. Thorns-like structures are present on the stems. And in Bahinia wahili, hook-like structures are present. The hook-like structures are mainly helps in climbing of the plant. And many plants' stems are strong and woody, cylindrical structure. And comes to the leaf. Comes to the leaf. Here it is the leaf. Leaf is petiolate. Here it is petiole is present. These are the petioles. Here it is petioles are present. These are called petiole. It is the leaf petiole. Petiolated leaves. Swollen leaf base is present. It is the swollen leaf base. Swollen leaf base. It look like a cushion like structure. Stipulate. Stipules are modified into spines in the Parkinsonia. Stipules are modified into ear like structure in the Cassia auriculata. The leaves belongs to monopinnately compound leaves. Monopinnately compound leaves. The monopinnately compound leaves means on the compound leaf primary axis, small leaf-like structures are present. The small leaf-like structures are called leaflets. The leaflets are in oval structure. They show dorsiventral regions, smooth surface in Cassia accidentalis. Here it is, these are the Cassia accidentalis. And in the Cassia auriculata, hairy surface is present. Smooth margin, terminal apex, reticulate venation is present in the leaf. And the leaflets are arranged in opposite manner on the compound leaf. In Cassia auriculata, homopinnately compound leaves are present. Homopinnately compound leaves means we count the leaflets, they are in even number, called homopinnately compound leaf. But in Cassia accidentalis, heteropinnately compound leaves are present. Heteropinnately compound leaves are present. Next comes to the inflorescence. Inflorescence majorly racemose-like structure. Racemose are corymb inflorescence. They are developed on the terminal part of the shoots. Or terminal part of the branches. Terminal part of the shoots or terminal part of the branches. Corymb inflorescence means here it is small flowers are containing small petiole and enlarged flowers are containing long petiole. These are arranged in a equal height of the inflorescence. So this type of inflorescence is called corymb inflorescence. Corymb inflorescence means all flowers are in same height on the inflorescence. All flowers are in same height on the inflorescence. Lower flowers are containing long pedicillate and terminal flowers are containing short pedicel. Finally, they are arranged in a equal height on the inflorescence. Now comes to the flower. Here it is, the flowers are pedicillate. Here it is the pedicel, pedicillate flower. Bracteate, bracts are present. Bracteoles are absent. Complete flower means calyx, corolla, androecium, and gynoecium is present. So the four major parts are present in the flower called complete flower. Bisexual, bisexual means androecium, anthers, and gynoecium. These are present in the flower. So these are called bisexual flower. Zygomorphic, zygomorphic means the flower cut into any two equal parts by only one longitudinal section, and diclamidous. Clamids means perianth. Perianth arranged in the two orals. Outer oral is called calyx, inner oral called corolla. Calyx and corolla is present in the flower called biperianth or diclamidous. And heteroclamidous. Heteroclamidous means they are changed into colors. They are changed into colors means here it is the calyx in green color. Corollas are colorful, mainly the yellow color. Yellow color petals are present in the Cisalpinaceae family. And pentamerous. Pentamerous, five petals or five sepals are present. Here it is, we count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five petals are and five sepals are present. Five means penta. Pentamerous flowers are present. And flowers are large in size. The flowers are belongs to perigynous. Perigynous means lateral side of the floral parts. Lateral side of the ovary. Here it is ovary. Lateral side of ovary, remaining floral parts are developed. The remaining floral parts are called calyx, means sepal, corolla, androecium. Corolla is also called petal. They are developed at the lateral side of the ovary, called perigynous flowers. That perigynous flower shows half superior or half inferior ovary. And we comes to the calyx. The calyx mainly five in number. They are free in position, but in Bahinia wahili, the sepals are fused in position. Bahinia wahili, five sepals are fused in position. They are green in color. In tamarindus and in saraka, only three sepals are present. In tamarindus and in saraka indica, only three sepals are present. In saraka, the sepals are in colorful. Colorful means the sepals are in colored. So that sepals are called petaloid sepals. Petaloid means petals like structure. Sepals are present in the saraka indica. Here it is, number five in the cassia species, like in cassia auriculata, cassia accidentalis, cassia fistula. The five sepals are green in color with quincuncial aestivation. Quincuncial aestivation means total, here it is, five sepals are present. From these five sepals, two ends completely towards outside. Here it is one, another one. Two sepals, two ends towards outside. And two sepals, two ends towards inside. Here it is one and two. These two sepals and sepals are towards inside. Remaining one sepal, one end towards inside, one end towards outside. This type of arrangement is called quincuncial aestivation. Quincuncial aestivation. And odd sepal present near the bracts are present towards bract side. These are the bracts. So next comes to the corolla. Corollas are mainly five. Here it is, corollas are mainly five. They are also polypetalous. Polypetalous means they are in free position. they are in free position. But in tamarind is only 3 petals are present. Tamarind is sepals are 3 and petals also 3. In Saraka indica, petals are absent because in Saraka indica only 3 sepals are present. They are in colorful. So that sepals are called petaloid. Petaloid sepals are present in the Saraka indica. But in Cassia species, 5 petals are present. They are yellow in color. They are yellow in color and free in position. But in Tamarindus, only 3 petals are present. They are large in size with colored petals. Large in size, colored petals. And ascending imbricate aestivation. Ascending imbricate aestivation means here it is 5 petals are present. From these 5 petals, 1 petal completely towards inside. Here it is 1 petal complete towards inside. 1 petal complete towards outside. It is another petal complete towards outside. Remaining 3 petals, 1 end towards inside, 1 end towards outside, 1 end towards inside, 1 end towards outside, 1 end towards inside, 1 end towards outside. This type of petals arrangement is called ascending imbricate aestivation. Ascending imbricate aestivation. Now comes to the androecium. Usually 10 stamens are present. They are arranged in the 2 orals. In each oral, 5 anthers are present. In each oral, 5 stamens are present. In Bahinia, only 5 anthers are present. In Bahinia, only 5 anthers are present. They are alternate with petals. Alternate with petals. Here it is in Cassia species, like in Cassia auriculata, Cassia accidentalis, Cassia fistula. From these plants, 10 anthers are present. The 10 anthers are arranged in the 2 orals. In each oral, 5 anthers are present. From these 10 anthers, 3 anthers are sterile. They are short in size. And remaining 7 anthers are large in size. Here it is, from outer oral, 5 anthers, 2 are sterile, 3 are fertile. In inner oral, 5 anthers, 1 is sterile, 4 are fertile. Basically, in Cisalpinaceae, like in Cassia fistula, Cassia auriculata, total 10 anthers here. 3 anthers are very short. These are the sterile anthers. 1, 2, 3. These are the sterile anthers. And remaining 7 anthers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The 7 anthers are fertile. From these 7 anthers, 4 anthers are in middle size and 3 anthers are in large size. 3 anthers are in large size. So 7 anthers are fertile, 3 anthers are sterile. And the anthers are diathecous, basifixed or adentifixed anthers. Here it is, the connective lobes with lower part of the thecas or basal part of the theca. The filament connected with basal part of theca or back side of the theca, called basifixed anthers. The basifixed anthers containing face, the face towards inside, called introres. The face towards inside called introres. The face towards gynoecium side called introres. Anthers are split in longitudinally, called longitudinal dehiscence during the dehiscence of the spores, means pollen grains. The pollen grains are in simple structure and the pollen grains are released by the longitudinal dehiscence and comes to the gynoecium. Gynoecium is the monocarpellary apocarpus, rarely in plant, some plants bicarpellary, if that bicarpellary also apocarpus. Majority of the plants containing monocarpellary ovary, the ovary containing, it is ovary, monocarpellary ovary, ovary containing long stalk-like structure, on the long stalk-like structure ovary is present. The ovary containing short style and the lobed stigma, short style and lobed stigma. Here it is, in each ovary or in each carpel, single ovule is present on the marginal placentation. Here it is the marginal placentation, single locule, it is ovary wall, it is the single locule. Locule means chamber, In each single chamber, only single ovule is present on the marginal placentation. On the marginal placentation. Here it is lower part of the ovary. Lower part of the ovary means from here, lower part of ovary. Nectary glands are present. The nectary glands are mainly helps in insect pollination. Insect pollination. So ovary belongs to perigynous or half superior or half inferior ovary. Half superior or half inferior ovary. Next comes to the pollination. Pollination done by insects. When they visit for nectar, cross pollination takes place in the Cisalpinaceae family. Next comes to the fruit. The fruit is legume. Here it is, the fruits are in the legume. Legume fruits are present in the Cisalpinaceae family. The Cisalpinaceae family fruits are legume. In tamarindus, indehiscent fruits are present. Indehiscent fruits means they cannot dehiscence. The fruit cannot dehiscenced by the longitudinal transfer. They are called indehiscent fruits. In Pterolobium, Samara fruits are present. And the seeds are, here it is, the ovary or ovule convert into seed after pollination. The seeds are dicotyledon, non-endospermic. Dicotyledon, non-endospermic. And next comes to the economic importance of Cisalpinaceae family. Food. The flower birds of Bahinia variegata are used as vegetable. The fruits of Tamarindus indica. The Tamarindus indica seeds containing starch. And the Tamarindus indica used as tamarind for cooking. And some plants are cultivated as a ornamental, Bahinia wahili. From Bahinia wahili, leaves are used as a paper plates. The paper plates are called leaf plates. Leaf plates are built by or synthesized by Bahinia wahili leaves. The leaves of Cisalpinia mainly used in curing of fever. So these are the economical importance of Cisalpinaceae family.